second valedictorian tonight. Kaitlin has been an active part of our school community throughout high school. She possesses a great work ethic, a commitment to others, a desire to lead, and a creative spirit. She has served on Student Council, National Honor Society, and the International Thespian Society. She's a member of the forensics team and is qualified for nationals 3 years in a row for her original oratory. She's a gifted writer and communicator, and received an award this year for an original one-act play that she wrote and directed. Perhaps she's becoming inspired to write like she's running out of time. It's been a privilege to have Kaitlin under our care for these past few years. She is respected by both teachers and peers because of her integrity, empathy, and genuine optimism and faith. Kaitlin is a deep well, thoughtful, and profound. If you're looking for a mind at work, look no further. Ladies and gentlemen, your 2017 co-valedictorian, Ms. Kaitlin Applegate.
Before I begin, I just want to take a moment to recognize my father. It's his birthday today. Dad, when I was born and you held me in your arms, the first thing I did was pee on you. And I just want you to know that the warmth that filled me that day as I relieved myself is the same warmth in my heart now as I graduate. Nothing gives me more joy than me and 39 other graduates stealing the spotlight from you on your special day. I love you. Just as my dad is celebrating his time on Earth tonight, we are all here to mark a significant milestone. We've spent about 4,512 hours in high school, which is equivalent to traveling to the moon 31 times, or listening to Queen's Bohemian Rhapsody over 40,000 times, or watching Napoleon Dynamite over 2,000 times. To my fellow seniors, I hope you have used your time in high school wisely. And if you didn't, good news, you have another 4 years to try again in college. Time pops up often in conversations. People will say, one step at a time, or remember that one time, or, and teachers, I'm sure you hear this a lot, if only I had more time. We talk about time so often because it's rooted in every aspect of our lives. Time is an ever-fleeting, valuable commodity. It's the one thing you can't buy more of, and the one thing we are all given. But the catch is, we don't know how much time we have, so we have to make it count. I want to encourage you to do three simple things tonight. Use your time to help others, honor God, and take opportunity. I first came to The Rock in eighth grade, and before that, I was homeschooled. Unfortunately, my experience with homeschooling had left me behind academically, especially when it came to math. I remember one day Mrs. Van Kirk held me back after class and asked me what my experience with math was like. I steeled myself and said, "Kaitlin, don't cry," and I immediately started bawling. I felt embarrassed and ashamed at my lack of ability. Thankfully, Mrs. Van Kirk was more than gracious with me. She told me that she would be able to give me extra help if I needed it, and introduced me to Mrs. Card, who agreed with her. Mrs. Van Kirk took maybe an extra 10 minutes of her time that day to encourage me. But let me tell you, those 10 minutes of help eradicated 12 years of feeling stupid, incapable, and like a lost cause. Because of Mrs. Van Kirk, I have gone on not only to pass my math classes, but to also tutor two students in mathematics and instill in them the very same confidence that Mrs. Van Kirk gave to me. I share this story with you because I want you to know how powerful time can be when you use it to serve others. 1 Peter 4:8 says that love covers a multitude of sins. So use your actions to bring healing to those around you. Because in God's kingdom, just 10 minutes of love can erase years of hurt and pain. Like time, God is always behind us, what lies in front of us, and what stands with us currently. So here's the second part of my encouragement. Don't be discouraged when you inevitably slip up when trying to use your time wisely. While God shares similarities with time, he is not bound by it. God is eternal, which means he has no beginning and no end. He sees the past, present, future, and is actively involved in all of them. So for all the times when you waste it, understand that God knew what you were going to do before you did it and has already redeemed all of your failures. And finally, understand that time is interwoven with opportunity. On that day after school, Mrs. Van Kirk had an opportunity to serve me, and she took it. Let me encourage all of you to do the same. Opportunity, in my experience, is impatient, so when it knocks, answer its call. And understand that no opportunity is insignificant. Luke 16:10 promises us that those who are faithful in little will inevitably be faithful in much. So to my fellow graduates, do not despise the days of taking small actions. Make new friendships, join diverse communities, take a challenging course, and one day you will find yourself on the other side of 1,000 small choices that have given you the courage to pursue your life's largest dreams. And to the friends, family, and faculty who have become our family, never underestimate the impact that your investment of time has had on our lives. When reflecting back on how to use your time to serve, honor God, and take action, remember the words of Theodore Roosevelt. He said, "It is not the critic who counts, not the man who points out where the strong man stumbles, or where the doer of deeds could have done them better. The credit belongs to the man who is actually in the arena, whose face is marred by dust and sweat and blood, who strives greatly, who errs, who comes up short again and again, but who does actually strive to do the deeds, who spends himself in a worthy cause, who at best knows in the end the triumph of high achievement, and who at the worst, if he fails, at least he fails while daring greatly, so that his place shall never be with those cold and timid souls who neither knew victory nor defeat." I am confident that the graduates here tonight will live out Roosevelt's charge because they already have for 4 years. You are all the risk takers, the ones who stand out, the ones who taught our teachers to have patience when we were too much to handle, which was basically every day, and the ones who take advantage of every second they are given. So here's to the graduating class of 2017 and all of the marvelous people who have helped us reach this point in time.